Live from the KGSPT radio studios in San Francisco, California, it's the Bagged and Bored Sports Show. Now here's your hosts, Rich Rosenbag Gallup and Brian, the Sports Bore Ekberg.
Hey everybody, welcome to the show. We'll be taking you through the morning commute talking sports, talking video games, and maybe talking some sports video games while we're at it. Brian, hey, things look a little different right here this morning. What's going on?
You got that right. Well, me and the Rosenbag are going Hollywood on you this morning. We've got a camera crew in the KGSPT radio station, and, you know, they've been following us around all morning.
It's true. They've entailed you to your last bathroom break, and that was like 30 minutes long. What's the deal?
Well, you know, I got a PSP. What do you want? But, you know, now that we got a camera crew here, your whole witness protection program thing is out the window. But you know what? We're not here to talk about running from organized crime.
Right you are, sports boy. We're here to talk about baseball. Spring training's finally done, the opening day rosters are set, and we've got a ton of baseball games to talk about.
EA may own the NFL market, but the MLB belongs to everybody. Well, except for EA, that is. I mean, thanks to a Take-Two deal with the MLB earlier this year, EA's out of the baseball publishing business, leaving only Take-Two and the first-party publishers as the remaining players in the baseball market.
And now that Acclaim and its All-Star Baseball Series have both gone the way of Roberto Alomar, we've only got three players in the baseball market, not counting Nintendo's recently delayed Pennachase Baseball. But the question is, Brian, which game that's available now is the best?
That's right, because only the very wealthy or those with $90 can afford all three baseball games. We're here today to talk about all the hardball games to find out which one is most deserving of your Skrilla.
Skrilla?
Yeah, it sounded weird to me too.
First up is MVP Baseball 2005, EA's final MLB console effort for the foreseeable future.
Well, provided they don't finagle a way to bring back high heat for Microsoft or something like that.
Keep hope alive! Whoa! MVP Baseball is yet another excellent effort from the gang at EA Sports, one that garnered a sparkling 8.9 in our view for its mix of compelling gameplay, good-looking graphics, and not one, but two franchise modes. Brian, do we have a caller?
We sure do. Dan from Monroeville is on the line, and he wants to talk about MVP's graphics.
Danny, what you got for us?
Bring it!
Hey, Rosenbag. I'd just like to say that the graphics in MVP Baseball 2005 are excellent.
What? Dude, are you drunk? MVP is one of the best-looking baseball games ever made.
Yeah, someone needs to stick the drug-sniffing dogs in this guy because he's clearly a tweaker.
Tweak.
MVP is more animated than Nomar's batting stance, has player models that are big and more solid than Mark McGwire's arms, and has some of the best-looking and most realistic stadiums this side of Fenway.
Hey guys, I totally agree with you.
Get off my radio station! Next caller!
Hey Sportsboar, we've got a special treat. It's a female caller.
Ah, first one of the year, Julie from Mountain Brook. Bring it!
Please bring it!
Hi guys, I need help describing MVP Baseball 2005's owner mode to my boyfriend.
Wait. Your boyfriend?
Yeah, his name's Don, and I've been telling him how the owner mode in MVP is a lot of fun.
Julie, are you calling us and telling us that you have a boyfriend?
Get off my airspace! Next caller, Hal in Redondo Beach! For the love of all that is holy, I please beg you, bring it!
Bring it!
Hi fellas, I want to talk about the MVP commentary team of Dwayne Kuiper and Mike Kruko. I think they do a really good...
Yeah, that's great, Hal, whatever. Yeah. I mean, dude, I can't believe Julie had a boyfriend. I thought we really connected.
It's messed up! I mean, why even call us? She's right about the owner's mode in MVP, though.
Right.
You know, it's cool how you can take control of every little aspect of your team's finances, like you can set concession prices, promotional days, like Rosenbag bobblehead doll day.
Yeah, man.
Even build up a custom stadium from scratch with all the funds you make.
Yeah, well, she's probably got bad breath anyway. Next caller, Tom from Worcester, Mass. You don't have a boyfriend, do you?
No.
Then bring it!
After this call is over, I want you to have brought it!
Thanks, guys. Long time, first time.
Excellent.
Anyway, I think as good as MVP looks, it plays even better. In fact, it may be the most playable game of the year. There's so much control in this game.
Oh my god!
What?!
Is this a prank call?!
Seriously, I don't know what games you were playing, Tommy, but MVP is probably the most sterling gameplay of any baseball game this year.
Yeah, I mean, an improved pitching mechanic, a power meter for fielded throws, hell, the game even lets you control the types of slides you pull off when you try to swipe a base. If there's anything to love about MVP 2005, it's the gameplay. You, sir, clearly have rabies.
Rabies.
But that's what I said.
Get off this AM frequency!
Boy, we gotta move on. 99 Sports is back with another baseball game. MLB 2006 is a game that's shirking the normal bargain bin filler duties of most 989 games. In fact, the game has a few innovations of its own. We've got an expert online, Dr. Irvin Snyder from Cal State Fullerton. He's here to discuss MLB 2006's career mode. Dr. Snyder, are you there?
I'm here, guys, and can I just start off by saying, go Expos!
Yeah! This is Montreal's year, baby! Go Spos!
As you were saying, Doctor...
Yes, well, MLB 2006 Career Mode is an interesting twist on the season or franchise mode found in many sports games. One that puts you in the position of an up-and-coming player trying to make it in the big leagues. You can complain about your playing time to the manager, old player meetings, you can complain about the lack of chemistry, or even go behind your teammates' backs and take your grievances straight to the media. In effect, it's a New York Mets simulator mode.
Hey, Doc?
Yes, Rich?
Brian and I have been talking while you were yapping there, and we both decided that you did indeed bring it.
Yeah, I mean, even though we'd, like, totally missed what you said there, I think it's safe to assume that it has been brought.
Yes.
What is this it? What did I bring?
Get off my radio station!
So that's two games down. It looks like MVP is the king when it comes to gameplay and graphics, but when it comes to intangibles, MLB 2006 has got it wrapped up. But we've still got one more game to look at, Major League Baseball 2K5.
That's right. If the developers 2K Sports...
By the way, Bags, can I just mention that the graphic beneath my name is wrong? It's Sports Boar, not Sports Boar.
Uh-huh.
B-O-A-R, like a big pig with tusks that runs through the forest and watches sports. Jeez!
Anyways, Hogzilla, MLB 2K5 developers will have a heck of a job next year if they hope to improve on the game's presentation, which, thanks to this year's ESPN license, ranks far and above anything else we've seen.
Yeah, I mean, the broadcasting duo of John Miller and Joe Morgan do a great job putting together lively commentary that sounds great and is accurate to the action on the field.
You might say that they bring it?
Miguel from Phoenix, I want to talk about MLB 2K5!
I'd just like to say that the online play in MLB 2K5 is awesome. Got all sorts of leagues that you can play. It's really easy to set up, and it even has integration with the ESPN video games website. It's like the best online baseball game this year.
Miguel, why you gotta lie to us?
Why
must you fill the airways with your lies?
I mean, if anything, MLB 2K5 has the best online play out there, with support for like a trillion players, silky smooth performance on both PS2 and Xbox. I mean, it's got it all.
Yeah.
Baba Booey?
Yeah, so if you want gameplay and graphics, go with MVP. If presentation and online play is your thing, MLB 2K5 is your choice. And if you're looking for a compelling new take on America's pastime, MLB 2006 is your cup of tea, Rich.
Thanks, Brian. So that's the baseball wrap-up for 2005. In our next hour, we'll be looking at what locked-out hockey players are doing now that the NHL has canceled the season. Uh-huh. We'll be talking with Kyle MacLaren and Patrick Marleau, currently starring as Sully and Boo in Monsters, Inc. on Ice down at the San Jose Pavilion.
I hear Bettman brought it in the Wazowski role.
Oh, no. But first, let's check traffic with our KGSBT intern and former San Francisco Demons backup place kicker, Bob Kalaiko. Bob's up in the KGSBT traffic and weather copter high above the 280. What's up, Bob? Are you going to bring it?
Holden ZS, kicker!